So in this class we are going to discuss the reflection of electromagnetic waves by a perfect dielectric at normal incidence. Already we have discussed for this normal incidence case by a perfect conductor. There we have concluded that whenever the electromagnetic waves are coming and hitting the surface of the conductor, the entire thing will be reflected back. And let us see what happens whenever the electromagnetic waves are touching this perfect dielectric at a normal incidence. So now let us say that this is nothing but the boundary, and which is separating the two mediums like this. This is nothing but the medium 1 and this is nothing but the medium 2. So instead of telling this medium 1 and medium 2, I can say it is the medium of incidence, that means incident medium, and this is nothing but your transmitting medium, transmitted medium, and you can say, and the waves also may be reflected in the same medium like this. Okay, let us assume that the electromagnetic waves are coming and hitting this surface of this perfect dielectric like this. So the waves are coming like this. This is called incident. And some part of the energy may be reflected back if it is not so perfect. So that will be the reflected wave. That is nothing but ER. But most of the energy will be transmitted to this second medium. This is called ET. So as it is a wave, I can say it is having also magnetic field components EI, HI, ER, HR, and ET and HT. And remember friends, medium is always characterized by three parameters, epsilon, mu and sigma. I can say that it is having epsilon 1, mu 1 and sigma 1. And here it is epsilon 2, mu 2 and sigma 2. And particularly write down the expression for the intrinsic impedance, eta 1 is equal to root of mu 1 by epsilon 1. And this is nothing but intrinsic impedance eta 2. Therefore, eta 2 is equal to root of mu 2 by epsilon 2. So, this is nothing but the incident medium, and this is the transmitting medium, and this is the reflected medium. Ancheta, whenever you are sending the wave with some energy here, most of the energy will be transmitted. A part of the energy may be reflected back if its loss is zero, if the loss is there. Okay, ఇక్కడ గనక లాస్ ఉంటే గనక సమ్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కూడా జరుగుతూ ఉంటుంది. అండ్ అబ్జార్ప్షన్ ఆఫ్ పవర్ ఎట్ ద ఇంటర్ఫేస్ కూడా ఉండదు ఇఫ్ సిగ్మా ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. నౌ లెట్ అస్ రైట్ సమ్ బేసిక్ ఈక్వేషన్స్ ఫర్ దిస్ కేస్. అండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్ మీడియం, దిస్ ఈజ్ ట్రాన్స్మిటింగ్ మీడియం, అండ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ రిఫ్లెక్టింగ్ మీడియం. అండ్ యు నో ద రిలేషన్ బిట్వీన్ ఈ అండ్ హెచ్. ఈ బై హెచ్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏటా. దిస్ రిలేషన్ ఇస్ ఆల్రెడీ నోన్ టు యూ. Using this relation, I can write down the equations now. EI is equal to eta 1 times HI. Let it be the first equation. That means incident electric field is equal to eta 1 into HI. Similarly, reflected components ER is equal to minus eta 1 into HI, HR. This is the second equation. Because why it is minus? ఇలా వెళ్తున్నది ప్లస్ అనుకుంటే రివర్స్లో వస్తుంది మైనస్, కాబట్టి మైనస్ వస్తుంది. సో మైనస్ ఇస్ ఇండికేటింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కమింగ్ ఇన్ ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్ బట్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ మీడియం. ఇట్స్ మీడియం క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్ ఇంపిడెన్స్ ఈజ్ ఈటా 1. దట్స్ వై మైనస్ ఈటా 1 ఇంటూ హెచ్ఆర్. కమింగ్ ఫర్ ద ట్రాన్స్మిటింగ్ కాంపోనెంట్స్ ఐ కెన్ సే దిస్ ఈజ్ ఈటీ అండ్ హెచ్టి. దేర్ ఫార్ ఈటీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఈటా 2 ఇంటూ హెచ్టి. దిస్ ఈస్ ద థర్డ్ ఈక్వేషన్. Because ET is equal to eta 2 into HT means transmission takes place in the second medium. Incidence or reflection ee medium lo untai. Lopalaku velipoyindi rendo medium kabatti the transmitting medium. So that's why eta 2 untundi. Characteristic impedance root is eta 2 is equal to root of mu 2 by epsilon 2. And coming for this next equations, I can say EI plus ER is equal to eta A plus ER is equal to ET, and HI plus HR is equal to HT. So let it be the fourth equation, and this is nothing but the fifth equation. And you can say EI plus ER is equal to ET. Incident electric field plus reflected electric field is equal to transmitted field. You may be thinking that it is minus, but I am telling that it is a vectorial addition. Whenever you are substituting the values of electric field intensity, ER meer negative value substitute chestar. That's why it is right. So EI plus ER is equal to ET, HI plus HR is equal to HT. So from these five basic equations, I can establish the relation between incident field as well as the transmitted field as well as the reflected field. Meer ent incident chestunte ఎంత ట్రాన్స్మిట్ అవుతుంది, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్. ఎంత బ్యాక్ వస్తుంది, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ రిఫ్లెక్టర్ కోఎఫిషియంట్. సో దేర్ ఆర్ టూ కోఎఫిషియంట్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ హియర్. రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ మీరు ఇస్తుంది ఎంత, పై బ్యాక్ వస్తుంది ఎంత. దట్ మీన్స్ టౌ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఐ కెన్ సే ఈఆర్ బై ఈఐ. దిస్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్. ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ మీన్స్ how much you are sending, how much you are actually transmitting. That is called transmission coefficient. Tau is equal to, I can say that, ET by EI. So these are the two things I would like to calculate here. Tau as well as reflection coefficient. Now, if you want to calculate this, I can take this fifth equation as the basic equation here. HI plus HR is equal to HI plus HR is equal to, what is HI? So for the convenience I am writing this here. This is EI is equal to eta 1 times HI. ER is equal to minus eta 1 times HR, and ET is equal to eta 2 times HT. So this is the first equation, second equation, and third equation, right? So from HI plus HR, from the fifth equation, HI plus HR is equal to HT. What is HI? EI by eta 1. What is HR? ER by minus eta 1. So 1 by eta 1 common into EI minus ER. That is equal to how much? HI plus HR is equal to how much? HT. What is HT from third? ET by eta 2. This is ET by eta 2. So what is ET? ET is nothing but EI plus ER. So EI plus ER by eta 2. This is the way of writing this equation. Now develop the relation between this and this. Therefore, you are going to write here 1 by eta 1 into EI minus ER is equal to EI plus ER divided by eta 2. Just cross multiply it. You are going to get the relation between ER and EI here. So ER by EI is equal to eta 2 minus eta 1 divided by eta 2 plus eta 1. This is nothing but tau, which can be called as the reflection coefficient. So what do you mean by the reflection coefficient? Reflection coefficient is defined as the ratio of reflected field to incident field. This is eta 2 minus eta 1 by eta 2 plus eta 1. So now, once you know this reflection coefficient tau, I would like to calculate your transmission coefficient tau. This is gamma and this is nothing but the tau. So what is the reflection coefficient? Gamma is equal to ER by EI. And what is the transmission coefficient? ET by EI. So you know here, EI plus ER is equal to ET. Okay, EI plus ER is equal to ET. EI plus ER is equal to ET. I am just dividing with EI here. 1 plus ER by EI is equal to ET by EI. This is nothing but the transmission coefficient. What does it mean here? If you want the transmission coefficient, simply add 1 to your reflection coefficient here. So tau is equal to, I can say tau is equal to 1 plus, you can say gamma. Therefore, tau is equal to 1 plus eta 2 minus eta 1 by eta 2 plus eta 1. Therefore, your tau is equal to, tau is equal to, transmission coefficient is equal to 2 eta 2 by eta 1 plus eta 2. Most important expressions, friends. You have to remember this. One is the reflection coefficient. Everywhere, these concepts are very much useful because meer enta pampincharu, enta transmit ayyindani cheppedi transmission coefficient. పంపించిన దాంట్లో ఎంత రిఫ్లెక్ట్ అయ్యిందని చెప్పేది రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్. సపోజ్ మీరు బిజినెస్ స్టార్ట్ చేసినంతే ఎంత క్యాపిటల్ పెట్టారు, ఎంత వెనక్కి వచ్చింది, ఎంత వర్కౌట్ అయ్యింది, మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ హియర్. ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ హియర్ ఆల్సో హౌ మచ్ ఎనర్జీ యు ఆర్ సెండింగ్, హౌ మచ్ ఈజ్ ట్రాన్స్మిటింగ్, హౌ మచ్ ఈజ్ రిఫ్లెక్టింగ్ బ్యాక్. ఈ ఎంత రిఫ్లెక్షన్ వచ్చింది అని చెప్పేదేమో రిఫ్లెక్షన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్, ఎంత ట్రాన్స్మిట్ అయ్యిందని చెప్పేది ట్రాన్స్మిషన్ కోఎఫిషియంట్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, I am teaching a lesson to all your students. Whatever I am sending is nothing but incident field. Yanta mi burrulloki ekkindi, yanta meeku ardhamayindi ani cheppedi transmitted component. Nen cheppindi enta ardham kaakunda na vaipu enakku vachesindi reflection coefficient. A good teacher has to see the values of reflection coefficient zero. Na vaipu ki edi raakunda anta meeku ardham avvali. And the transmission coefficient must be equal to 1 and reflection coefficient must be 0. For a good teacher, like for an excellent students also. So the for getting that mechanism, you have to calculate these values. So your ER by EA and tau is given as 2 eta 2 by eta 1 plus eta 2, your tau. So what is eta 1 and eta 2? Eta 1 and eta 2 are nothing but intrinsic impedances. Intrinsic impedances. I would like to write in terms of your medium parameters. Okay, we know that eta 1, intrinsic impedance of the medium 1, is equal to root of mu 1 by epsilon 1, and eta 2 is equal to root of mu 2 by epsilon 2. Mu 1 and mu 2 are nothing but the permeabilities of the medium. It is almost equal to the vacuum permeability. Mu 2 is equal to mu 1 is equal to mu v. This is nothing but the vacuum permeability. Now, I would like to substitute these values in our reflection coefficient formula. Eta gamma is equal to eta 2 minus eta 1 by eta 2 plus eta 1. That means this is equal to root of mu 2 by epsilon 2 minus root of mu 1 by epsilon 1 divided by root mu 2 by epsilon 2 plus root of mu 1 by epsilon 1. As I told you, mu 1, mu 2 are almost equal to mu v. This can be simplified as root of epsilon 1 minus root epsilon 2 divided by root epsilon 1 plus root epsilon 2. So the reflection coefficient is expressed in terms of permittivities of the medium. Remember, maximum dependence is only on permittivities of the medium. If you know epsilon 1 and epsilon 2, happily you can calculate your reflection coefficient ga. Similarly, you can substitute for your transmission coefficient tau is equal to 2 eta 2 divided by eta 1 plus eta 2. So that is equal to tau is equal to 2 root epsilon 1 divided by root epsilon 1 plus root epsilon 2. This is nothing but your transmission coefficient. So these are the expressions for the reflection coefficient and transmission coefficient in terms of E. The same thing also we can discuss in terms of H also. So how to do this? Reflection coefficient gamma is equal to minus HR divided by HI. That is equal to eta 1 minus eta 2 by eta 1 plus eta 2. Because very simple, it is minus of this. So that is equal to, and you can, after the substitution, you can write down root of epsilon 2 minus root epsilon 1 divided by root epsilon 2 plus root epsilon 1. Okay. Similarly, this tau is equal to 2 root epsilon 2 divided by root epsilon 1 plus root epsilon 2. This is nothing but the transmission coefficient for H, that is equal to, this is equal to HT by HI, and this is nothing but HR by HI minus of this. So in this way you are going to establish the relation between incident field, reflected field and the transmitted field. Most of the times he is going to give the problems on this concept, because it is the most practical concept out of all these concepts. Because whenever the wave is actually hitting the surface of the dielectric here, this is called incident wave, part of it will be reflected back and most of the things will be transmitted. Meeru pampinchindi incident wave, vellindi transmitted wave, venakku vachedi reflected wave, enta transmit ayindi transmission coefficient, enta reflect ayindi reflection coefficient. So these are very much useful whenever you are calculating the percentage of power that is reflecting back, the percentage of the power actually transmitting into the medium. Okay, I hope you understood this concept, and we are going to do some problems based on this concept. Okay, thank you.